luggage or laundry. So we use different L's. That one's a little bit more of a made-up L, but an L nonetheless. Alright, so 7 L's, hang checks every single time. Now we're at Rotowin, so we're back up to the top. So from the top, we're looking up again. We see that our primary release mechanism here is shut. We got metal touch and metal mat closed. Our weak link here is in good shape. We've inspected it, no extra frays. Let's follow the black cable. No kinks, no tangles. Our primary release handle, where we like it. Now, the rest of this really, we can't exactly check it until we're hooked up to the airplane. Right. I was hooked up to the airplane here. Bicep against it sometimes. Right. It's very easy to take off like that. Barely hold on to it. At the safety jet, we're pushed forward. And then, up here, here's an extra brace. So here's just the tape. Alright, then wheels are straight, pointed down the runway. Nothing in front of us. The plane's in front of us, nothing in front of the plane, nothing that we're going to run into on takeoff. Wind good, except for the launch cycle. Good. All right.
So first
problem. Yes. That I want you to get inside that. Yep. Also, a lot better. Good. All right. So, aerotowing. One of the big differences from flying free flight is you have this tow force pulling on your chest. So you know all about cross control from your hang gliders. Right, we really want to lead our turns with our hips and feet. Even more important, aerotone. If you just move your shoulders one side or the other, you're changing where the plane's pulling you from. So it's worse to cross control aerotone than it is in free plane. So really, we want to pretend our chin is almost drilled into the center here. We really want to keep this toe point stationary and engage the core. Tighten your muscles, hips, and feet through your turns. So I really exaggerate the start with.
Was it?
Oh, it's just a little extra strap. But